Glory to God. Good evening. Good evening. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm trying to go live on. God bless you, Deja. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to be talking about relationships. They matter. Relationships matter. And I just welcome everybody from Facebook Live and Instagram Live. I'm trying to do this for the first time, both of them. And so I pray everyone that watches will be blessed by this brief message, amen, that I will try to do. Amen. And I bless everyone that will watch me on Instagram and everyone that will watch me on Facebook Live. Amen. So today we're going to talk about relationship matters. God, I thank you on today. Oh, God, I thank you. I give you praise. I give you glory, God, for your goodness, for your mercy. I pray that you minister to your people, that you give us a heart, oh, God, that is pleasing to you, God, that we may treat one another with respect, that we will treat one another with honor in the name of Jesus. And I just pray, God, that your Holy Spirit ministers to each and every person that will watch the replay and that will watch live in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Well, I hope everyone is having a good evening. Amen. As we are on Tuesday, amen. And I feel like this month is just going by so quickly. The month of February is just moving right by. And so God bless you. Dios te bendiga, Leslie. God bless you. So if you see me looking another way, it's because I'm on Instagram too. I'm trying to do both of the lives at the same time. Amen. So but relationship matters. Good evening. Yes, last week I couldn't come on because I was in Miami. Amen. We had to go to Florida to a conference, and so I couldn't get on Facebook Live for last Tuesday and Thursday, but this week I will. I'm back on. Amen. Glory to God. So I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about relationships. It's very important, you know, as we read in the Bible, whenever we read about God's people getting into trouble or having problems, the root of every problem usually has to do with relationships. It usually has to do with relationship. So relationship matters. It matters. First of all, we are serving God and we need to have a relationship with Him. Amen. So that is the first one, that we have to have a relationship with Him. But then he just doesn't want us to stay there, that for us to just have a relationship with God. God bless you, Allie. God bless you, my husband. Bless you, everybody. Love you. Share the video. We're going to talk about relationship. February is the relationship month. Amen. And I just want to touch a little bit about this. And then I want to also do a Facebook Live probably on marriage, some relationship with marriage and the singles. So maybe I'll do that for the next 2 weeks left in February. Amen. And so today I just want to talk about relationship matters. It matters. Amen. Usually when people have problems, you can trace it back to having a problem that is rooted in some type of relationship. Usually when people have problems, it's going to have to do with relationship, whether it's you have a problem with your ex, with someone, your best friend, or it's got to do with relationship. So every problem that we face is going to have to do with relationship. And so it is very important that we understand how God views how we must develop a relationship, not only with Him, but He wants us to develop relationship with one another. The scriptures is full of scriptures, how He even gives parables comparing how we must, amen, be in relationship with one another. Anytime God is going, God bless you, Rico. Anytime God is going to bless you, He's going to bless you and it's going to come through a person. Anytime God is going to bless you, the blessing is going to come through a person. God is going to send a person. Relationships matter. Amen. God, you cannot do this on your own. It wasn't intended for us to be alone. Do you remember what God told Adam and Eve? He told Adam, it is not good for man to be alone. And that's not just including, you know, we can say that, yep, God created Eve, amen, for Adam. But he said, it's not good for man to be alone. We were not created to be alone, amen. God did not create us to be that way. That's why when you see people get thrown into prison and into jail, you know, and when they don't behave good, they put them in solitary confinement. They put them in solitary confinement because that is the worst punishment. Because people need relationships. We need relationships, amen. We grow together. We are better together, amen, hallelujah. So I'm going to just try to teach this really quick, and whatever I don't finish, maybe I will continue the next Tuesday. But it's so important. Relationships matter. It matters, amen. Life is built on relationships. Life is built on relationships. And the quote that I put is that, if you know, that many say, it is not what you know, but it is who you know. And that part of the equation, that our relationships have a huge impact. It have a huge impact on the person that we are and the person that we become. It depends on, God bless you. God bless you, Pamela. Yes, I'm trying to do Instagram and Facebook Live at the same time. So if you see me looking away, Facebook, is because I'm trying to do both of them. God bless you guys. Thank you for tuning in. I pray that this bless you. Amen. So life is built on relationships. People, and I don't know who quote this, and I think it's Dale Carnegie or John Maxwell, but it says people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care about them. People don't care about how much you know. So relationships is so important, amen. It is important. You can get far going by yourself, but you can get, you know, you can go fast and go a certain distance when you are by yourself, but you can go further when you do it together. You can go further when you do it together, amen. So, you know, the scripture, let me read you what the scriptures. I'm going to give you a few scriptures because I want you to see what the scripture says about how God sees that we must work together. Romans 12 and 10 says, be devoted to one another in brotherly love. The Christian life involves more than just believing. It also includes belonging. We grow in Christ by being in relationship to other Christians. We grow in Christ because there's people that be like, I'll just have church at home. I'll just stay at home. Uh-oh. I don't need to go to church. Uh-oh. I can do this by myself. Uh-oh. Watch it. I'm going to give you some scriptures. I'm going to give you some scriptures because I want you to see what God sees. I want you to see God's perspective and why he wants us to have relationship and why the body of Christ, that's why he compares the church as the body of Christ. Why does he say that? Because remember, the arm can't say to the feet, I don't need you. The eye can't say to the ear, I don't need you. That he was comparing a physical body to members of a church. He was comparing us being members of the body. Amen. He was comparing that, amen, to a physical body, meaning that we need each other. We need one another. Amen. That's what he was trying to let. That's why he says, do not forsake the assembling together of the saints. Hallelujah. This is the scriptures. He says, do not forsake the assembling. That means the coming together. The coming together. Do not forsake it. He said, don't forsake it and act like you need one another. Amen. We need one another. And I'm going to give you more scriptures. So first of all, God never created us to live separately and independently of each other. It was not his plan. He likes it when his children care for and nurture each other. He loves when his children care for and nurture each other. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So let me read Proverbs 18:1. Don't look, don't let the enemy isolate you. Don't let the enemy, he wants you to become isolated and be a lone ranger, to be alone. Amen. He wants you to do things on your own, but that is not the will of God. That is not the will of God for you to be a lone ranger, amen? Because that's why people, usually, if you have dealt with people that have been suicidal and have been depressed, one of the first things that they do, tell me what they do. They isolate themselves. They go into a room all by themselves to be alone. They don't want nobody. Why? Because the enemy loves it when you isolate yourself. He loves it when you are all by yourself, because that's when discouragement comes. That's when depression. That's when you know you are full of your own thoughts. Your own thoughts are tormenting you and you don't have help from somebody else. So the enemy loves and he feeds on it when you isolate yourself. He loves it. For him, it's a playground. He says, I'm about to have a playground with this person. They are all by themselves. And I'm going to give you scriptures. Amen. So Proverbs 18:1, it says, a man who isolates himself seeks his own desire. He rages against all wise judgment. The Bible says, a man who isolates himself seeks his own desire. Amen. So this is Proverbs. Amen. That was Proverbs. That was King Solomon, the wisest king. He said that. Amen. He said this. So it's not good. It's not good for, don't let it happen. Don't let the enemy isolate you. Don't let the enemy keep you separated, because we're better together. We are better together. Amen. So, you know, so God compares, us as a body. He also makes a comparison as God's temple. We are God's temple. The church is like the temple. Amen. The building. You need, look, in a temple, in a building, you need for every stone and every piece to be in place in order for there to be stability. In order for there to be stability. A building cannot stand alone unless all the materials are all connected and working together. A building cannot stand unless all the materials are connected together and supporting, amen, each and every part, amen. So God talks about a building. He compares us as a building, amen. So this is how God is trying to explain, amen, what he wants us to understand by giving us metaphors. So he gives us the metaphor of a body. He gives us a metaphor of a building, amen. And building cannot stand unless every material part is connected and working together, amen. Are you with me? Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So there, you don't belong on, look, you will not feel, you belong in the body of Christ. You belong together. But if you don't get connected, you're going to feel that disconnect. Amen. You're not going to have that encouragement because look, if you light up a flame, if you light up matches and they're all together, they will all stay lit. Amen. But if you take one away, amen, then there's a disconnect and you won't get the fire. So it is important for you to be, when you are discouraged, for you to stay connected. You're not meant to do it on your own. You're not meant to do it on your own. Amen. So there's going to be time where you need the family of God to hold you together, or you will fall. Look, there's going to be times in your walk where you need the family of God, where you need encouragement, where you need somebody to pray for you, where you can't do it on your own. You're not almighty. Only God is almighty. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You are not almighty. You need somebody. We were created to do this thing with other people. We were created, amen. And every blessing that you will ever receive is going to come from a person. It's not all going to be you. It's going to come with God sending people to you and bringing the blessing to you. Amen. Glory to God. Let's read Romans 1:12. It says here, I mean that I want us to help each other with the faith we have. Your faith will help me and my faith will help you. This is the NCV translation. Romans 1:12. It says, your faith will help me and my faith will help you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So you have to be more than just someone that just, you know, some people, they just, I'm just going to go hear the word of God at the church, and I don't want to be bothered by anybody. Well, let me tell you, that is not the way God wants you to work. He wants you to connect. He wants you to be a member, not just a spectator, not just one that just comes here. He wants the connection. He wants you to belong. He wants you to connect, because when you connect, that's when your life is going to begin to catch on fire, because whatever you're missing, your brother or your sister can come behind you and light you up in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. God bless you, dunamis power. Amen. You that are watching. Yes, brother, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. So it is important for us together, amen, to do things. Relationships matter. Look, if you want to go fast, this is the African proverb. If you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. Go together. Amen. It's one of my favorite quotes. Amen. Look what Ecclesiastes, and I'm just giving you scriptures now. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9 through 12. It says, two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated. But two can stand back to back and conquer. Woo! Three are even better, for a triple-braided cord is not easily broken. Hallelujah. Are you hearing what God is saying? Hallelujah. We are better. Relationship matters. We're better together. We're stronger. We're better. We're wiser. Amen. We are supposed to do this together. You were born to live connected to people. You were born to be connected to people. Amen. You will not know. You know, the scripture talks about in Colossians chapter 3, verse 12 through 15, it says, since God chose you to be holy people he loves, you must clothe yourself with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others. Above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds us all together in harmony. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule your hearts. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace and always be thankful. Hallelujah. How in the world are you going to be able to learn how to be forgiving, how to walk in humility, how to walk in gentleness, how to be kind, how to be merciful, do sacrifice and make a sacrifice for somebody? How are you going to learn about dying to self and putting others before you, or having humility? How in the world are you going to learn how to walk in humility, how to walk in kindness on your own? Oh, hallelujah. Yes, yes, yes. We are not meant to do this on our own. Relationships matter. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How do I know? Amen. I said this before. You know, I'm just going to stay home and watch Facebook Live. My pastor, I don't need to go to church anymore. I can just watch videos and I can just do everything on social media. Okay, I get it that we are in a new, you know, we are in a social media age, and I'm okay because I watch videos. I'm not against it. I learn, amen. I learn of teachings. I understand that. I'm with you. I understand. But the Bible says, do not forsake the assembling together of the saints. And he says it for a reason. He's not just saying it just to say it. He's saying it for a reason. You cannot learn how to die to yourself. I don't know your your character unless you are being tested by other people. Amen. How do I know that you love right when you are always at the house? I know I'm telling the truth. I know I'm saying the truth here. Hallelujah. I know I'm speaking the truth. How are you supposed to learn what sacrifice is all by yourself? How are you supposed to know how do I know that that pride spirit ain't still in you if I never see you in the house of God and you're just behind the closed doors and all you're doing is watching videos and you don't know how to relate and have relationship with people? I don't know. I don't know. And guess what? God knows that you need one another because iron sharpens iron. Iron sharpens iron. Hallelujah. You ain't gonna be sharpened by nobody if you are a lone ranger. Relationships matter. I'm gonna know if you got pride, if you got humility, if you got kindness. I'm gonna know that until I can see you working in relationship with other people. Oh, glory to God. I'm going to be able to see your character and you're working together with other people. I don't know what you're doing when all you're doing is say, I don't need to go to church. I'm just going to watch videos. I'm just going to watch the pastor online. And I'm okay with you watching pastors and preachers. I'm okay with that. But you know what? You need to get yourself in and get planted in the house of God so that we can see your character and we can refine some things and get the pride out of you and get all of that stuff that you still mean and you still unkind, and I don't know what you got going on because you're always at home. Oh, oh yes, Jennifer, you funny. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. We got to see each other. Hallelujah. So are you hearing what I'm saying? You know, look, because we're living in a day and age where people say, I believe in God, but I don't need to go to church. I believe in God and I'm going to pray at home, but I don't need to go to church. That's why your character is messed up. Because the way you are, your character begins, the more it's through pressure. It's through process. It's through process that I'm able to see your character when you go through something. Yes, because in every family, including the family of God, there's going to be sometimes when people rub you in the wrong way or a sister say something that you don't like. But guess what? When that happens, I'm seeing your character because pressure lets me know what you're made of. Pressure will bring to light some things that I didn't know was there. And I need to see it. As a leader, I need to see it because then I can say not to dismiss you, but to say, okay, we need to work on this area. I'm sister. We need to work on this area so that you can grow. You will not grow on your own. You there's only so far you can really grow. There's only so far you can really go on your own. But you will grow. You will go further. You will go further with depth and character. Amen. You will grow further when you do it together. Amen. We were not meant to do this on our own. God created us to need one another. And like I said in the beginning, the worst punishment anybody can have is when you are thrown into prison and you get solitary confinement. Because we are not meant to do life on our own. We are naturally, we need to have that connection to people. We naturally need to connect. We naturally need to connect. Amen. Glory to God. So the scripture I just read, he said to clothe yourself with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, and humility, and gentleness, and patience. I'm not going to be able to do none of that that the Lord is saying for me to clothe myself if I'm doing everything on my own. I'm a lone ranger. I don't need nobody. How I'm going to show gentleness? How am I going to show kindness? I know you're getting my point now. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is what I'm saying. Relationships matter. Relationship matter. And this is how we grow. We need one another. We need one another. Amen. Hallelujah. We can't walk this thing alone. We can't do this alone. We can't go on this faith journey alone. We need one another. Amen. The devil wants you to worship self. He wants you to worship self. He wants it to be just about you. That's what that is the devil. But God, when it's God, look, I heard we were listening about a teaching video with my husband and I love what the pastor said. He said this, you know, and it's amazing because this is what I've said also in my life. We build people. We are in the business of building people. We are in the business of building people. And I'm not saying this is a business, but this is our focus is on building people. We don't use people to build a building. We use a building to build people. Hallelujah. We use a building to build people. We do not use people to build us a building, but we use the structure, the building, to make it so that we can build disciples, so that we can build people, so that we can teach people that they can come out of the rut that they're in and they can come out of living the same old thing that they've been living all their life, that there is something better on the other side. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The devil wants you to worship self. God wants you to honor one another, carry each other's burden, pray for one another, be kind to one another, be a part of the body of Christ, be a member, help one another. Hallelujah. Forgive one another. It's never self-centered. Anything ever God does, it's never self-centered. It's always about each other. It's always about each other. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says any kingdom divided against itself will come into ruins. And a house divided against itself will fall. A house divided against itself will fall. That's why we got to be together. We cannot have division. We can't get separated. God wants that unity. God wants that together for us to come together. Are you hearing what God is saying? So the scripture says, and that I quoted Luke 11:17. I quoted that. Jesus knew their thoughts and he said to them, any kingdom divided against itself will be ruined. A house divided against itself will fall. Amen. Hallelujah. So if your family is divided, it will fall. If your marriage is divided, it will fall. It cannot stand. It cannot stand. God bless you, Karen. Hallelujah. God bless you, daughter Selena. God bless you. Amen. New York. God bless you. Glory to God. So anything that's divided, if a city is divided, if a house is divided, if your family is divided, it will not stand. If your marriage is divided, it will not stand. The devil knows that he does everything possible to cause problems. He does everything possible to bring division. He does everything possible to keep people separated, because there's power when we come together. There's power when we come together. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's why you can't allow criticism and people pointing fingers and gossip and all of that to bring division. Because the root of division, the root of all of that, all of those things of strife and gossip and murmuring and all of these things, the root of all of that is pride. And humility is the root of all love. Humility is the root of all love. Amen. Glory to God. So we must be able to stay together and work out with each other, forgive one another. Amen. We have to be on guard because the enemy is always trying to bring division. And unforgiveness keeps us divided. Unforgiveness keeps us divided. Unforgiveness keeps us divided. Forgive, amen. And let us come back together. Let us come back together, amen. Glory to God. Relationships matter. Look, in the scriptures, Ruth needed Naomi. In the scriptures, Ruth needed Naomi. David needed a Jonathan. The children of Israel needed Moses. They needed Moses to deliver them. We all need somebody. Joseph needed his brothers. It put him in the palace. Amen. Esther needed her uncle. Amen. He gave her advice. Everyone needs somebody. We all need somebody. And we are meant to do this together. We are meant to do this together. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible. So remember Ecclesiastes. And I love that scripture. I usually use it for marriages. Two people are better off than one. Two people are better off than one. Amen. And I'm going to leave you with that scripture. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9 through 12. I'm going to read this and then I'm done. Amen. But we were born to live connected. We were born to live connected to people. And every blessing and every promotion that comes your way, any blessing, any divine connection is going to take people, relationship. That's why you must value people. Treat people right. Treat people with kindness. Treat people with love. Amen. You don't know who can connect you. You don't know who is going to be the one that God will use to take you to the next level. You don't know. But treat people right. Treat people right always. Learn how to listen to people. Don't always try to talk and make sure that you're the what you got to say is the only thing important. But learn how to be humble. Learn how to listen to other people's opinions and love and value their opinion. Love and value what their thoughts are. Amen? Relationships matter, man. We all need each other. And we're meant to do this together. We're not meant to do this on our own. So two people are better than one. For they can help each other succeed. They can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated. But two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better. Hallelujah. For a triple full cord is not easily broken. Hallelujah. I hope this has been a blessing. Amen. I'm telling you, there is a great epidemic even with our youth. They feel so alone. They isolate themselves. There's a big epidemic of loneliness. Amen. There's so many people that feel disconnected and alone because this is God wants us. Amen. To be with one another. Amen. I mean, he wants us to help and to uplift one another with our faith. Amen. So relationships matter. Relationships matter. Don't stay home. Go to your church. Go to a church and connect. Don't just be a spectator. Connect. Because when you connect, you're going to receive. You're going to receive. Amen. And you know, and I can't go keep going on and on, but God compares the body of Christ to a body. God compares us to a temple. God compares us to the vine. Amen. To the vine. And if we're connected to the vine, we will bear fruit. He compares this. Amen. All of these comparisons, he's trying to let us know that we have to be connected. That we all need each other. Amen. That every part is so important. Amen. Hallelujah. And I can't know your character until you face and you have relationship with other people. That's where I can see what your character is made of. When you get under pressure, I'm going to see your character flaws. You're going to see, well, I thought I had that together, but I guess this person pushed my buttons. I guess I really needed God. I need God's grace for this part of my life. That's when you realize it. Don't be a lone ranger. Don't be alone. Remember, the enemy wants you to isolate. The enemy wants you to be alone. But the power is in coming together. Amen. We are better together. We will go further. We will do great things. It is amazing what you can do when nobody cares who gets the credit. All we want to do is get the goal done. And that is all that matters. Amen. So let us work together as people, a body of believers. Let us come together, help one another, pray for one another, carry one another's burdens. Amen. And uplift one another. Amen. Glory to God. Well, God bless you guys. Yes, I'm on Tuesdays, Jessica, Tuesdays at 9 a.m. I mean, not 9 a.m., 9 p.m. Tuesdays at 9 p.m. in English and Thursdays at 9 p.m. in Spanish. Amen. Last week, I couldn't come on. I was in Florida. But I'm doing Facebook Live right now and Instagram Live and Facebook Live. Amen. At the same time, I guess I figured it out how to do Instagram Live, so I'm going to continue. I haven't really built up the Instagram. I get in at 9:30, but you start. Amen. Yes, I started doing it a little early because I've been getting off so late when I did it at 9:30. Because, you know, I used to go on Facebook Live at 9:30, but then it'd be like 10 something and I was still on here. So I wanted to come in half an hour earlier. So I'm doing it at 9 p.m. Amen. Hopefully I can stick to that, you know, unless something happens and I might have to push it to 9:30. But amen. So I'm glad I got Instagram running. I'm trying to build the Instagram page. So I wanted to start doing the videos there because I have friends also on Instagram. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, you can follow there, Pastor Sarita Castro. And we're going to talk about relationships the month of February. We're going to talk about marriage relationships, and we're going to talk about the singles too. Amen. We're going to talk about both of those things. That's what I'm trying to do for this month of February. Talk about relationships. Amen. So I wanted to talk a little bit about this topic, about relationship matters, and probably do next week, do for marriages. Amen. Relationships. And you, even if you're single, you need to watch it because you got to get ready for your marriage. You got to get married for the marriage, right? You need some tips. And all of us that are married, we can always use some more tips to continue our marriage being lit up on fire. We can't let the fire go out in the marriage. We can't let the fire go out. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. God bless you guys. We got Woman Be Free Conference. Yes, I almost forgot. Woman Be Free Conference. Please register. Eventbrite. Amen. I have everything on the Facebook page. If you need tickets, we have those tickets ready also. Please come to the Woman Be Free Conference. It's going to be amazing. March 28th. I'm telling you, we're going to deal with some things. You're going to leave out of there very refreshed and free and empowered. You're going to leave out of there. Look, all of these things that have been holding you back, God is going to deal with some of these things because it's time for your purpose to be birthed out. It's time for you to come into the delivery room, and we're gonna get you ready for what God, because look, this has been a preparation time for you. Let me prophetically prophesy that to you. It's been a time of preparation, but the time is coming to an end, and it is getting ready to be birthed out. What God has for you, what you are supposed to be doing in this season and in the years to come, is getting ready to come to the forefront. If you didn't know what you were supposed to do, I decree and declare that if this Woman Be Free Conference, that you're going to have vision, you're going to have clarity, and all of those confusion and anything that was holding you back from walking into your God-given destiny and purpose, God is going to deal with those things that have been sabotaging you, that have been holding you back. God is going to break them off of you because it's time for the woman of God to arise. You are the apple of his eyes. You are, amen, you are his beloved, and it is time for you to walk in what God created you to walk. You are a splendor, a crown of glory in the hands of our God, and he is getting ready to display what has been hidden in you. It's getting ready to come on display, what's been in you and what the enemy has been trying to hold back. God is getting ready to bring it forth in display. God bless you, Lisa. God is getting ready to bring it forth to the forefront. We're getting ready to we're getting ready to see it. It's getting ready to be the time of revealing. It's getting ready to be seen. Amen. I'm telling you, God is going to do something amazing in that conference. So I just encourage you, if you need tickets, amen, we have them. It's $25 to get into the women's conference. We're going to have breakfast and lunch. And we're going to give you gifts because we want you to, you are a daughter of the king, and we're going to treat you just that way. You are a daughter of the king, and you're going to feel very loved, very welcome. You're going to just enjoy, and you're going to receive something for your spirit, for your soul, and for your body. Amen. You're going to receive all three. Every part of you is going to be blessed. Amen. You're going to be there. Yes. Yes. And if you need, have any questions, you can send me a messenger. Amen. You can purchase a ticket personally, or you can do it online. Everything is online. Amen. If whatever way you want to do it. But we are going to have an exciting, it's going to be exciting. Oh, it's going to be amazing. I'm telling you, it's going to be so beautiful. I'm just excited because we're just getting, it's getting close to the time. And it's going to be beautiful. I want every woman to feel so special, because that's who you are, very special to God. God, you know, as women, we are very special to God. And we are a threat to the enemy. We are a threat to him. Amen. So I know the enemy better watch out, because you're coming forth. You're getting ready to walk in your God-given destiny. It's coming forth. No more holding things holding you back. Amen. Glory to God. Well, God bless you guys. I pray you have a good night. Amen. Share the video. I pray that this was a blessing. Share the video. We're at church tomorrow at 7 p.m. Please come to the Bible studies, powerful Bible studies. Yes, I'm excited too, Lisa. I'm so excited. Yes, this is going to be amazing. Amazing. I'm just excited. Yes. Hallelujah. Well, come to our, get up and shout, sister. God bless you, Kyle. Amen. It's going to be powerful. Yes, it's going to be powerful. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, I'm telling you, this is going to be amazing. I'm going to be doing some videos, little short videos on this. I'm going to be coming on, any questions, Q&A, whatever you guys want to, questions that you may have. I'm going to come back and do something for the Woman Be Free conference. Amen. But God bless you guys. I love you. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for taking your time. I pray this really blessed you, and share the video. Amen. So others also can be blessed and understand that relationships matter, and that every blessing that will come to you, God is going to use someone. Promotion is, he's going to use someone. Every blessing, everything about how God created us, we need each other. Relationships matter. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God bless you guys. Love you. If you didn't watch the video, watch the replay. God bless you, Rachel. God bless you.